In this tutorial, we're going to look at making a pie chart. And to do that, I made up a sample of fictitious people's favorite pies. And apple, 27 people picked apple as their favorite. 9 people picked cherry as their favorite. And this is a fictitious survey, so it's not based on any real data. Now, one way to make the chart is we can highlight all this data. But another thing is, just like in our sorting and groups that we've seen before, if I just highlight somewhere in there and click on my chart, it automatically selects this whole group for my data, and it creates a column chart. Now, the first thing that it asks us for is a chart type, so that's a column. To do a bar chart, I click on the bar, and it shows me a little preview here. Now I'm clicking to pie. That's the one that we want to work with, the pie chart. So we're okay with that. And now we want to go to the data range. And it's telling us that this is correct. If we didn't like this data range, if it didn't select it properly, I can click this little select data range. And then I would just highlight the area that I want. And it grabs that. Now it says, is this the correct data range? We say yes. The data is in rows, and the first row is a label. So we're good with that. The data series, we'll review that in the next tutorial, and the chart elements, we'll review that in the next tutorial. So we click finish, and now we have our chart out there, and it looks kind of funny, so I need to click off it to make it set into the sheet here. Okay, we've clicked off the chart to set it into the spreadsheet, but if we wanted to go in and make some edits, we'd click on it again, and we've got these green boxes around it, which tells us that we can move the chart itself at this point, or we can resize just as we would if we had inserted a picture into this spreadsheet. Now, to edit the chart itself, we need to double click inside here. And it changes to these gray lines. Now with the gray lines, we can edit the type of chart we have. We've got a pie chart. To change that, I click right onto the chart. And I can change the chart type to the bar or come back to the pie. Clicking OK. Now I want to change the color of some of these because the apple is blue and the blueberry is red. So let's try and change the blueberry to blue. So I select that section, format it to blue. So now we got our blueberry blue. We're going to our key lime, and we're going to make this more of a key lime color. So we're going to go up to like a bright green like this. Alrighty, and our lemon meringue, it's yellow, but let's see if we can make it a little brighter yellow. We have this yellow here. Oh, that's too yellow. How about yellow 2? Okay. The next one is cherry. We want to make this one a red. And the last is the apple, and we want to make this one a green. Okay, so now we've got the colors matching up. That's how we would change our colors. And if we wanted to change the font here, we just right-click on the format legend here. And I can change the font to, it gives you a little sample down below what it would look like. We don't like that. And Gothic. Let's just go with the reference sans serif. Maybe we want to bold it. And clicking OK. And then, of course, we can move this around too. Move it up or down. And let's put a title on here with the right click and insert titles. And for our main title, we're just going to say pie chart, people's favorite pies. And we want to move this over a little bit to the right. Now, on our research, we just had more people come in, so I'm changing this number from 27 to 47. We just had 20 more people, and they liked the pie chart. They liked the apple. So clicking on that, it changes the chart just by changing the data. So that's pretty cool here. Now we have more people liking cherry, but we don't want to do the math, so we say 9 plus 14. 14 more people like that. Whoops. I forgot to say equals, though. Equals 9 plus 14. And there's our cherry pie updated. So that's a quick review of how to insert. Oh, one more thing. For you people that have the higher graphics cards, let's change this chart type. I'm double-clicking, and I need the gray area. There we go. Changing the chart type. And we want to make this the 3D look. See, now we got the 3D. If I click here when I have the red, I can alter it, make it the sides here will go up and down. So you can have some fun with the 3D here with our chart type. I think that with the red, what if I just double click to the green? That's to resize it in here. And then, of course, when you got the four arrows, you can move it around as you like and stretch it as a chart. So fun stuff to play with and to show your data in a chart.